Hello. It was not just a ping-pong game. We were together. First thing, we want to show we are serious. So we were willing to come here today, one from France, one from Italy, after the soccer game yesterday evening. So it's really something serious. We are looking to the result of our work, not on football. Anyway, good for Italy. So, certainly, the point, as Dominic already said, is absolutely important to us. We absolutely, as an operator, absolutely believe in standardization. We invest a lot. Every one of our companies has hundreds of his best technical people working in the various standardization groups, participating in all what is it possible. Certainly, our need is standardization also to take this point as a serious, high, very high priority issue. For us, it's absolutely a high priority issue because the OPEX for energy into our network is the biggest OPEX we have, and it's continuously growing. It's nearly not sustainable economically. So to do that, we need to work, probably as yesterday was said, we are just discussing about 2%. Okay, but let's start with this 2%. Let's do something, not only talk about things and wait someone else to get out some miracle. So we have to act, and we are now focusing on the key areas, so the key areas in terms of potential on energy consumption. Access, of course, access. Now we are facing the next generation network deployment. We deployed our last generation network, very massive. It was POTS, ISDN, digital systems. They were deployed in the late 80s, beginning of 90s. Then we added in parallel ADSL from 2000 on. But now we are talking about renewing everything, maybe canceling what we already have. Like with FTTX, we could simply shut down our central offices, forget our copper, and bring directly optical fiber to our customers. These are enormous investment. This is enormous interest for the community. But certainly, the decision we take today or in the next few years will have to get their burden for the next 20 years. So we need to speed up, certainly. Access is one of our key points. Data centers, of course, as network operators, we have data centers for internet, for all other things. A rough calculation says that we are running nearly 10% of the world's data centers as telecommunication operators. And we are the biggest single owner of data centers. In data centers area, standardization can really help. As an example, transporting to the data center world, the experience we got in telecommunication on powering, on the environmental condition, what has proved to be efficient and has allowed us to be more efficient in the last years, that can be brought there. So we have really to work also in this area. And then all of the core, the metro, even if its impact today is quite limited. But if we really want to achieve the result, we must not forget anything. We must really try to act on all areas. Every area you face, you find a new opportunity, and especially an opportunity for standardization. Customer networking, yeah, that's a big problem because we are bringing broadband, and then we are bringing a lot of gizmos, of appliances in the customer premises for home networking and all other features. These are additional. So yesterday, so in these days, we have said, okay, ICT is 2%. we must work, otherwise it will become 5% maybe. If there is no clear view, strategic view, also in developing the service, it's important developing service from end to end. Not only you can get advantages in reducing the power consumption of the single equipment, but it's important to develop services or the complete network or the end-to-end chain in such a way that it can exploit the maximum advantages possible. As an example, not only minimizing the single energy consumption, but bringing having a relation from the energy consumption and the real service that is delivered. So having something that can change, that can follow the real usage of the customer. Cooling, as we said, efficient cooling is a key issue. It's a key issue to reduce the power consumption. When we are talking about equipment installed in the streets, near houses, it's also a matter of, being of people living in these houses, because cooling very, very often is the highest producers of noise, and then highest producers, we know, of complaints. So this is something that we have to work. Then there are so we have these areas, our action. So we have we are able to get together all these operators. We started with the operators first because we are those in this moment that have the boiling potatoes in our hand. We are spending money, and the amount of money we are spending, we have to do something. We cannot postpone it. So and then we also are very strongly contributing to standardization, and we request also a lot from standardization. I was really liking Matt's words yesterday, saying, okay, it's good to look back, but we have to look forward. And we have not to be satisfied of ourselves and also of the other. We have to ask more, absolutely, in that area. So, of course, contributions in our areas, talking about energy efficiency, they are towards European Commission. This code of conduct, they were a bit strange at the beginning, but of course they have been they have proved to be an engine or a starting block that started a movement. Now, already in these couple of days, we heard many times talking about that. Even if few companies, also my company, has not yet signed that because it's legal things, but we are all applying industries. They are developing in this view things that from a lot of time we are not able to achieve. And then all the list of various bodies we heard also in this session. It's quite encouraging, but of course we must be quite on the spot, quite pushing, because otherwise we will not get things in due time. Also towards vendors, of course, and this is again our network operators, in this case, responsibility, because if we have to prove we are serious, so we must not only have our purchasing policies based on capex, on the cost of purchasing, but on the total cost of ownership. So this can really change the grading, the result of tenders. And this is the real way to show also from our side that we are really serious. As time is going, and I wouldn't like you to starve too much, I would try to go maybe to the to the end. Okay, the end is the annex. So let's let's just remain on some key points we want to say. We want to enable efficient broadband. We need. It's the interest of the nation. It's also in the interest of our companies. It's a matter of business. This of the energy efficiency. Energy efficiency needs to rethink standards, but also something more, some services, architectural part. We actively support and we push everybody to support standardization activities. A small point. We also are very keen, very careful on the customer side equipment, because of course we are the biggest again single buyer of modems and other customers' set of box and other part of equipment, because we are then selling or lending to our customers. But in this process, we have the possibility to move industries to better equipment. The single customer doesn't have such a voice. So this is also social responsibility from operators in this case. We want certainly to avoid that this famous 2% becomes 5%. But we would like to reduce, being able to deploy wider and wider services broadband, so to enable further reduction with services and other things. We do believe it is really possible. Thank you.